U.S. President Joe Biden speaks with leaders of Qatar and Egypt as he pushes for a ceasefire deal in Gaza. A spokesperson for Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi says the call also touched on the exchange of Israeli hostages for Palestinian prisoners, a main sticking point in negotiations between Israel and Hamas. Biden also discussed developments in the situation in the Gaza Strip with Qatar's Emir Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, whose country is mediating in the conflict. A Hamas delegation is currently in Cairo to deliberate on Israel's response to a ceasefire deal.
There has been new progress in talks, and currently the onus is indeed on Hamas. There is a deal on the table, and they need to take it. We believe that all efforts need to be brought to bear to convince Hamas to accept the proposal immediately. It is on the table. It is way past time to get these hostages home. It is way past time to get to a ceasefire.
Pro-Palestinian protests at U.S. universities continuing at full force despite skirmishes with pro-Israeli groups and the police. In New York, a mid-afternoon deadline set by Columbia University for an end to the demonstration passed without any visible action taken by the school or police. The university's president says days of negotiations had failed to persuade demonstrators to dismantle the dozens of tents set up to express opposition to Israel's war in Gaza.
I think the power and collective strength demonstrated by the students is incredible, because it seems like every day or every other day or so, the university comes up with some arbitrary deadline, and rather than scaring off the students, we come back stronger and more strong together than we ever had before.
So students are currently holding their ground and refusing to be scared by the administration's fear tactics, and we're here in solidarity with Gaza, who continues to hold their ground on their indigenous lands, so we won't be leaving.
The previous police attempt to remove the encampment at the Manhattan campus triggered dozens of similar protests at colleges across the country. Civil rights groups have criticized police violence at campuses in Atlanta and Austin, where dozens were taken into custody before charges were dropped for lacking probable cause. The White House says it is up to universities and colleges to determine the need for police presence, but stresses the right of the public to protest.
As far as police presence, that's up to the colleges and the universities. That's for them to decide. And we have to be able to allow Americans to peacefully protest within the law. That is important, and that's what the president wants to see. It is important for Americans to have the right to peacefully protest. We understand this is within the law, and we understand this is a difficult time, and we're going to call out any type of hateful rhetoric.
A Russian missile strike in Ukraine's Black Sea port of Odessa kills 4 people and injures 32 others. The region's governor says the missile hit an educational institution, adding at least 7 of the injured are in serious condition. The Ukrainian Navy says Russia used a type of ballistic missile with a cluster warhead that is harder to intercept. Odessa has been a frequent target of Russian missile and drone attacks, particularly in its port infrastructure. Well, let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.
Good morning to the friends of the Rundown. Here are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. We begin with U.S. President Joe Biden taking a jab at his Republican opponent, Donald Trump, during the annual White House Correspondents Association dinner.
81-year-old President Joe Biden delivered an election year roast on Saturday night, chiding his Republican rival, 77-year-old Donald Trump, for immaturity.
I'm a grown man running against a 6-year-old.
Biden also referred to Trump's historic criminal trial over hush money paid to porn star Stormy Daniels.
Donald has had a few tough days lately. You might call it stormy weather.
Trump is the first former president to face criminal charges. The trial, which is expected to run through May, could be the only one of his 4 criminal prosecutions to be completed before the November 5 election rematch with Biden. Trump told reporters at the Manhattan Criminal Court on Friday that he had invited Biden to debate him on national television.
We're ready. Just tell me where.
On to news in the National Football League draft. The Philadelphia Eagles selected Filipino-American Johnny Wilson.
The 2024 NFL draft has recently concluded in Detroit, Michigan, and at least one Filipino-American is headed to the pros. The Philadelphia Eagles selected Phil-Am wide receiver Johnny Wilson in the sixth round of the NFL draft with the 185th pick. Wilson, who attended high school in Calabasas in Southern California, spent his first two collegiate seasons at Arizona State before transferring to Florida State for two seasons. Wilson is a large wide receiver standing at 6'6" and weighing over 230 pounds. After leading the Florida State Seminoles in all receiving categories in 2022, he finished his college career as third-team All-CC this past season.
And finally, the Louisiana State University women's gymnastics team celebrated their first national championship this past week, and among the newly crowned champions is LSU junior Filipino-American gymnast Alea Finnegan.
A seven-time All-American and the newest NCAA floor champion. She's a 2024 Olympic qualifier, the Lee Summit, Missouri native, Alea Finnegan.
During the victory rally, the Filipino-American gymnast took to the stage to speak about how she was feeling before her championship-clinching beam performance. Aside from team gold, Finnegan also nabbed the individual national championship in the floor exercises.
I think I was most excited, which is kind of hard to believe I'm saying. I looked at my team before I went. They had all the trust and all the confidence in the world in me, and so that was basically the best thing that I could possibly bring out into that beamer team.
The 21-year-old Finnegan has qualified for the Summer Olympic Games and will be representing the Philippines in Paris with fellow Phil-Am gymnast Levi Jung Ruvivar.
And those are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our TFC News on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News, and head on over to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manotok. Back to our friends at The Rundown.
They say history repeats itself. And for global pop superstar Taylor Swift, it surely does, only better. Taylor once again dominated the entire top 10 of Billboard's Hot 100 chart with songs from her latest album, The Tortured Poets Department. As if that's not enough, she actually occupied the chart's top 14 slots, and all of her 31 new songs landed on the list. Taylor thanked her fans on social media, saying they've outdone themselves. To recall, Taylor first dominated the entire top 10 of the Billboard chart with her Midnights album back in October 2022. The pop star's latest album has been breaking records since its release on April 19, debuting with 2.6 million album sales in the U.S. alone.